Hey, what's up? It's BJ from This Old Family Home. I am installing a handrail in a basement set of stairs, and this handrail is gonna have a bunch of spindles on it. And right now I have a house that is not passing code because it doesn't have a handrail. Kids or drunk people could be coming down the stairs and just fall over, and they're falling up to 8 feet, so that's not good. Where I'm at now is in order to do this, I needed to replace the treads and risers because I was gonna need to do it eventually. They were in pretty poor condition and there were no risers, which is just makes it a little more scary for kids coming up and down. So I got all that, and now I'm working on this newel post. This newel post is very simple. I chose to go with an old newel post instead of something new from Home Depot. Ended up being kind of roughly the same price. This was a $50 newel post. It's solid oak. Versus if you go to Home Depot and you'll buy one of the box newel posts, and those are also about, I think they start at 35 bucks, but quickly go up to 100. But we're trying to restore some of the old character into this historic house in a historic district. So right now, I'm trying to figure out how to attach this so that it is strong, so that when kids are swinging on it, it will not move. And the way I've decided to do it is this newel post is going to be anchored to this 2x, I ripped it, it's a 2x7.5 inch, used to be a 2x10. And on the other side, it will be anchored against the concrete using TAPCON screws, and I have an angle bracket. It'll be actually anchored on the other side, but if I can make the fastening between the newel post and the 2x7, if I can make that strong enough, then it will take care of this lateral force. I'm worried about the force in this direction. The force in the direction up and down the stairs is gonna be taken care of with the handrail. So it's just that side to side. All right, right now I am doing some very fancy drilling, fancy in terms of really, really hard to get to. And I chose not to do bolts or anything like that, but I'm trying to screw from the bottom side. You probably can't see any of that, but and screw into the back side of this newel post. So I'm gonna put a ton of screws, literally probably about 8, and that should be a pretty secure way of fastening it. Oh, and by the way, I'm countersinking a lot of these screws because that 2x, I mean, it's a 2x, so it's 1.5 inches thick. I'm using 3-inch screws, and it's also going through a 3/8-inch thick piece of plywood that I'm using as the riser. Anyway, I needed to go farther into the newel post, so that's why I'm countersinking it. With this, by the way. I think I'm learning why people use bolts. This screw's snapped. I'm screwing into a hardwood, so that hardwood is just gonna hold on to the screw, and my drill is gonna also hold on to it, so this is what fails. I'm gonna try again. That was awesome. Okay. So I was shooting screws in from this side and also from this side. And when I would shoot a screw in from this side, then pull the newel post this way. And from the other side did the opposite. So I was just able to adjust the way it's plumbness. I screwed a screw in from the inner side, and it appropriately pushed the newel post over. So now when I'm looking at my level, the bubble is going in opposite directions by the same amount, which is due to there's a little bit of a taper on the newel post. So it is plumb, which I'm a little surprised. Okay, well, you know how I said I was gonna anchor this 2x7 to the ground using an anchor bracket? Yeah, well, while I was saying that, I had it completely sealed up with the tread. And so fortunately I was able to just knock it out with no damage to the newel post, because the newel post is slotted to accept that tread, but I was able to get it out without affecting anything. So now I can add in my brackets. I was singing to myself. I was happy when that came out without messing anything up. So life is good. I should probably look up actually how to use one of these masonry drill bits. I'm using it on a hammer drill, but this was a brand new bit and it completely dulled away and it looks like it's melting away. And when I first took it off, it was red hot. So yeah, if you know a better way, let me know. So I lined up the angle brackets and I marked and drilled the holes where they need to be. And then I screwed in the tapcon screws and took me a while to figure out exactly how to do it. Definitely do not use the slotted screw head. I take the time to find the hex bit and they'll go in like a breeze. Okay, both angle brackets are installed. Done with that. Now put the tread back and I'm ready to officially move on to the handrail. All right, so I had a bit of a design change. So there used to be top rail, bottom rail, balusters going between, but now I'm just gonna do a top rail, which is the handrail, and then have individual balusters come down and I'm gonna be able to do two per stair. The barrier, the challenge that I'm running into now is that there does need to be an inch and a half clearance between the wall and the railing. So this is 2 inches based on, that's just inherent to the hardware that I bought from the big box store. The challenge that I'm running into now is that it gets down to half an inch down here. So it's a combination of the squares not being stair, potentially the stairs not being square, and potentially the wall not being square. I'll let you know how it goes. Okay, made a minor adjustment. The handrail is gonna swerve out from the wall just a little bit. I think overall you're not gonna really be able to see it, but when you're sliding your hand down the handrail, you'll be able to get through here without any obstruction. So I did that with a 2x4 that's set against the joist, and now my hardware fits against the 2x4. So now we're back on track. Now it's time to put some balusters in now for the fun part. So I have the top handrail in place, held in place by some string, some twine, and I'm taking measurements on each baluster, cutting each one custom, and hopefully it'll go a little faster, but they are fitting in nicely. So on the bottom, you can see that I have dowel rods. So for on each of them. And then the same dowel rods are on the top. And so I've been marking where the bottom hole needs to be and then drill it, and then mark where the top hole needs to be and drill it. I've been using a plumb bob, which I have never used before. Where is it? Here it is. So it's actually a chalk mark line, and I had to hold it up at the top of the rail underneath here and then try to get the makeshift plumb bob as close as I can to what is this mark, which is a distance away from the riser, so that they end up being evenly spaced. And from that mark, which I mark on the top and the bottom, and then I drill the hole. And then so far they're fitting together. Okay, so you know you're supposed to measure twice and cut once. Well, there should be another step in there that's think three times, measure twice, and then cut once. So here, this spacing is correct. I just had to redo the spacing. That's what I'm getting at. So I had to take the run of the stair, which is the distance from the start of the riser to the start of the next riser, and I took that and divided it by 3. That's incorrect. So you can see that these two balusters are too close together, and the spacing would have been inconsistent. There would have been a narrower gap here and a wider gap here. So now hopefully I've done it right by dividing it by four. So if you divide by four units, four gaps, four units, there is one unit here, two units here, one unit here, then there'd be another unit down here. So total there'll be two units between these two balusters. Let's hope that looks good. I'm gonna go ahead and call this a little mini win because the spacing's now right. All right, the baluster installation is coming along. I have to measure each one custom, so that takes a little while. Today's Friday. I started this project last Wednesday. I'm just now getting done. I don't even have a job. How is that possible to go so slow? All right, but I'm wrapping this up. Next, I just gotta glue everything together. So you can see that all of the balusters are in. And they look okay. Most of them are pretty plumb. Newel post is solid. Everything's pretty solid. So now it's just time to glue it all together.
Gets up late for work. Mother has to iron his shirt. Then she sends the kids to school. Sees them off with a small kiss. She's the one they're going to miss in lots of ways.
Welcome to this episode of This Old Family Home. Welcome to your brand new stairs! My brand new stairs! Alright, here we got brand new treads and risers! That's jutted up against brand new balusters! And that's supporting your brand new rail! You don't like it when I do that?
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Do one of you guys want to go up our brand new stairs?
No.
Well, I will then. Here we go. Coming into stair number one. And there we go. I guess that was it. Only took a week and a half of work. Oh, I forgot to mention, there were two balusters that were a little unique. So this one was running into the supporting hardware for the railing. And so I had notch out around that baluster. And because I wouldn't be able to screw into the hardware if the baluster were in place already. So I had to, all I did was toenail it using two brads and seemed to work pretty good. So these bottom two balusters too, I had to toenail them in. That's not such a great example, but I wasn't able to use the dowel rods on them because, well, you can just barely see that I used a pocket hole kit to drill long holes into the railing here. And then the screw, there are two screws that mount the rail to the newel post. It's this guy. If you haven't seen one of these, the way they work, you hold it up against your surface and you can drill into these guide holes and you're able to insert screws. The screws will go partially, are countersunk partially into the wood And then the screw extends into the surface that you're trying to mate it, fasten it up against. All right, well, that project was not exactly exciting, but it helps us get closer to passing occupancy. I just have to install one more set of handrails and balusters, but that will be a lot more exciting. It's on the first and second floor, and it will actually be hopefully very attractive. This one was just trying to get the job done to make sure people don't fall down the handrails. All right, so if you enjoyed this video, or if you have any comments, if you've done a project like this before, have any pointers, I'd love to hear them. I'm not an expert, I'm just figuring this out as I go. All right, like and definitely subscribe to the channel. All right, see you next time, bye.